Hi, we're PolyOrbite, a Canadian team of engineering students from Polytechnique Montreal. We're happy to present to you our SAR. It's our third iteration of our Mars rover. In our first iteration, we came second place in the Canadian challenge. In our second iteration, so last year, we came first in our province. This year, we're hoping to participate in the URC so we can continue succeeding internationally in the rover challenges. Our team is composed of students from 11 different engineering fields. They work together in order to create a new rover that will succeed in all the tasks of the URC.
So my team was responsible for ensuring the proper integration of all the components together. So we had to integrate the structural components along with the power distribution and with the control system so that everything could work together. On top of that, it also needed to be modular to attach the robotic arm or science experiment. All of this had to work off our new 24-volt design with our custom batteries made to be easily swapped in and out. Last year, we had many issues at the Canadian competition with the power distribution, and namely our terminal, which had too many screws and that was really finicky. And so this year we designed our own, integrating a proper power distribution, monitoring, and safeties such as fuses.
The responsibilities of the control team this year were to improve the autonomous driving of the robot. In order to do this, we worked on a new interface which helped to visualize better the different sensors on the robot. For example, we improved the visualization of the batteries, the cameras, the GPS, and the encoders, and also the input of the joysticks in order to control the robot. In order to improve this, we took advantage of the differential driving system where each joystick controls one side of the robot's wheels. So we worked on the LiDAR independently from the robot, and now all that is left is to test it while having it implemented on the robot itself.
The structural team is primarily responsible for the primary mechanical systems of our rover, notably the structural integrity and propulsion parts of it. Well, this year we implemented new 3D printed wheels with a double layer dampening system that allows us to increase traction when rolling and also dissipate amounts of energy during high impact situations. This year we optimized the chassis of our rover, so we managed to reduce the footprint and thus the mass of the total rover. We also added a polycarbonate shell that allows us to easily access the electronic components and also protect them from dust and wind. Our rover is capable of climbing hills up to 35 degrees and traversing obstacles that are up to 52 centimeters in height. With all of these improvements and our classic rocker bogey suspension system, we are now better than ever equipped to navigate the difficult terrain at URC.
The robotic arms team responsibility this year is to conceive and manufacture a new robotic arm of 6 axes, 7 motors, 5 kilo payload, and a 1 meter reach. And having a gripper that can adapt to the shapes of the different objects with their 2 fingers. It has to produce it from A to Z in all the fields necessary, as the electrical, software, and mechanical.
The science team responsibility is to retrieve multiple samples from different soil types and analyze them to find life or determine if the life was extant, extinct, or present. This year we built the onboard assay to be able to analyze the samples on the rover, whereas before we always did it outside of the rover independently. We also need to align certain components that are unaligned. For example, the drill isn't able to completely drop its sample into the lab efficiently, so there is some optimization to do there, but other than that, most components are ready for use. At the moment, we can take 12 samples for analysis and 4 samples for further analysis outside of the rover.
I'm extremely proud of my team and everything they have accomplished. I'm confident we can succeed in the URC given that we participate. Thank you for considering our application, and we hope to see you in May.